Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2057, Understanding 538. Well, I'm a Cleveland Indians fan. If you follow baseball, American baseball, which means that in my entire lifetime, I've only seen the Indians in the World Series two times before this year, three times this year, and the Indians are ahead 2-1 in a best of seven series. They're fighting against the Chicago Cubs, who have had an even longer drought. Either team winning the World Series will be a great story. And I spend a lot of time at my favorite website, Nate Silver's 538. A lot of it for election coverage, but Nate is a baseball guy first, and he has these awesome statistics, and I live and breathe on these statistics. So right now, Nate is saying the Indians' chance of winning the World Series is 63%, and the Cubs' chance of winning the World Series is 37%. But these numbers fluctuate wildly after every game. And so using the ELO statistic and really advanced modeling, Nate predicts the outcome of each of the games. And look at this. The Indians aren't predicted to win. They're not predicted to win. They're not predicted to win. Finally, in Game 7, they're going to predict to win. They have to win four. Nate, how can it be that with you're calling three games against the Indians, they're going to win? Right? And so I needed to wrap my head around this. And of course, to wrap my head around this, I came in to Microsoft Excel. So I took these statistics, and these are rounded off. I'm sure that Nate has these out far greater percentages. I took the 49, the 34, the 49, and the 54%, put them up here. Those are the four games. And then a simple little formula here that says equal RAND. RAND gives us a random number between 0 and 1. If that number is less than or equal to the 49%, then I put a 1 for the Indians winning. So every time I calculate here, see, we have a different outcome to the series. Over here, an if statement. If the Indians win more than one game, in other words, if they win two of the remaining four games, they've won the series. And then here, let's get one where they actually win, a very inefficient formula to figure out whether they won in six games or seven games. All right, let's be fair. Calculate if the Cubs win and how many games they can win in. Of course, the Cubs can't win in five. Now they have to win in either six or seven. All right, so I'm going to model this thing 10,000 times, 10,000 times right there. So that whole big thing, every row here is a different possible outcome. And you see, there are a lot of possibilities where Cleveland wins, because even though it's more likely the Cubs will win the next game, there's still 49 times out of 100 that the Indians do win the game. And there's enough where the Indians win two to win the series. All right, so out here on the right-hand side, I have some statistics. These statistics are just adding up the number of times that the Indians win divided by 10,000, because there's 10,000 rows. All right, so there's 6,420 times where they win. In five games, 1,675. Six games, 2,478. Seven games, 2,275. All right, and then some more statistics out here, whether Cleveland wins in five, six, or seven, or Chicago wins in six or seven. Now, this is the result of 10,000 runs. 10,000 runs. And you can see here that 538 is saying a 63% chance of winning the World Series. And right here in 10,000 runs, I have a 64% chance. And this, a couple things. First off, Nate's model is far more superior than my simple little thing that I threw together here in Excel. Because in his model, once the winner of this game is known, he actually changes the percentages for the remaining items, right? And mine doesn't do that. But still, we're order of magnitude close. But let's not just run it for 10,000. Let's use that great trick that I learned from Professor Simon Banega, where we create a data table from a blank cell. Usually the top left corner cell of a data table in Excel is the formula. But in this case, I'm going to leave that blank. We're going to go to data, what if analysis, data table, and all we do is specify a column input cell of any blank cell. And because we have RAND back there, it will do those 10,000 calculations now 15 times. So here's the result of 150,000 runs of the World Series. So Cleveland in 5, Cleveland in 6, Cleveland in 7, Chicago in 6, and Chicago in 7. So right now, sure enough, there's about a 63% chance after running the model 150,000 times, that Cleveland's going to win the series. And tonight, Saturday, October 29th, the Cleveland ace pitcher, Corey Kluber, is going to be our starting pitcher on 3 days rest. And how important is it for the Indians to win tonight? All right, well, there's a really easy way to find this out. Now that we have this model set up, so I copied that data. And pay special as values, pay special formats, and then said, all right, if the Indians win tonight, so I'm basically going to change this to 100, which means that every single game in game four is a winner. And then we'll come out here and you'll see that there's now an 85% chance of the Indians winning the World Series and only a 15% chance of the Cubs winning the World Series. We'll paste this down here, pay special values, pay special formats. But let's go the other way. If the Cubs win tonight, they're playing at home, first chance to ever win a World Series at Wrigley Field in, what, 100 years. If the Cubs win tonight, it dramatically changes the playoff picture. All right, if the Cubs win tonight, then there's no chance for Cleveland to win in five. All of those have gone away. And we're down to a 43% chance of the Indians winning the World Series. So we go from a 63% chance to a 43% chance if, in fact, the Indians do not win on the road in Wrigley tonight. And hey, for all you Cubs fans, all you got to do is pull one out tonight, and all of a sudden, everything shifts back in your favor, and you now have a 56% chance of winning the series. Now, I tried to use the brand new treemap view here for illustrating this, and the treemap, while it's new, it doesn't have a lot of variability, and I chose some bad colors. I tried to use the two colors for the Cleveland Indians, their red and blue, and the Chicago Cubs, their red and blue, and it was just all too confusing, because what happens here is by default the tree map sorts in order: 24%, 22%, 19%, 17%, 17%. And when I put this out on Facebook, Jon Peltier, who of course has that awesome Maramenko chart utility, said, you know, it'd be a lot better if we reorganized it. So Jon took my data, thanks Jon, and created these charts that are a lot better than mine, and a plug for his awesome chart utilities that lets you create charts that you can't normally create in Excel. So here, this shows right now, before game four, 63% chance of the Indians winning. If the Indians win game four tonight, wow, 84% chance. But if they lose, we have less than a 50% chance, and the Cubs are likely to go on and win it all, possibly in game six is the most likely outcome there. So tip that to Jon Peltier for his awesome chart utility. I'll put a link to that down in the YouTube comments. You should check it out. Go Tribe.